what's up? Okay, so I'm going to do a video, and this is going to be a fast video, really, because when I first got into this product, I thought, oh, man, this is going to be a super complicated install. And you know what? It really can be, depending on how you're installing it. If you're installing Foreman with an existing Puppet instance, then it's a little bit more difficult because Foreman uses Puppet basically to do some of its install, right, instead to manage its own components. So basically, when you install Foreman, it installs a Puppet server at the same time. So, but if you just follow that basic installation, you don't try to integrate it with anything existing, any existing Puppet servers, Puppet Masters, Puppet Enterprise for sure, because I don't even think it works with Puppet Enterprise at all, then it's a pretty easy install. And we're just going to go through that really fast here. So basically, I'm installing this on Ubuntu 18.04. It's an updated Ubuntu 18.04. I already went through update and upgrade for the package manager, so there's nothing else to do. I don't have anything else installed on here. This is literally just a fresh install. So what I'm going to do is elevate myself, which actually I already did that up here. And so I'm root, and what we want to do is start installing some stuff. So this install instructions are from Foreman's installation instructions, and that link's right here, the quick start guide. So it's actually pretty easy. You just follow along with these. Installation doesn't take much time. Actually, we already have the CA certificates already on there. So for Ubuntu, we don't even need that. So we're just going to take that guy off. You don't even have to do it. This changes directory to temp folder. And then we go ahead and download a Puppet repository file. And that's just going to add it to the apt repos list so that we can install Puppet as part of the installer. And then Foreman has its own repositories that we have to add as well. And we're going to go ahead and put those in. Ooh, hope if I typed it right. So basically what we're doing is we're just echoing a particular deb command right into the sources. It's kind of a little bit different, I guess. This is like, hey, let's download a deb file that installs the package and then install that package. But this one must be a manual method of doing that. So, and then we're going to add a public key for accessing those repositories. And then finally, we'll do an apt update to update the repositories. And you can see Puppet Labs and Foreman are now added to the repositories, whereas before up here, they were not, right? These are the base four with an install. These are after I just did those other commands. So then the next thing you want to do is you actually you download through the repo, you're going to install what's called the Foreman installer. This isn't actually installing Foreman. It's installing Foreman installer, which will then install Foreman. It's kind of weird, but is what it is. So with Foreman, one of the things you have to pay attention to is DNS, because apparently it wants a FQDN, fully qualified domain name, associated with an actual IP address and not a local host IP address. It's just that 127.00 or 01, whatever it is. Anything in the 127/8 range. So anything in this range at all. So basically, if you were to write that with a CEDAR notation, it would look like this. And that means, that means anything 127 and on, which is how I wrote it there, 127.xxx. So basically what we want to do is we want to modify the host file. And you can see Foreman's added right here, right? So I'm going to delete that line, and then I'm going to type in a new line, and we're going to put in the IP address of this box. And then foreman.mydomainname. So in your instance, this would be different. You wouldn't use mine unless you used exactly the same IP addresses. So basically what I did is I took out the localhost Foreman, and I added in a IP address for Foreman at the FQDN. So, and then what you want to be able to do is ping the host name here, and it should ping back and resolve to the IP address, right? So there we go. Okay, so the next thing you're going to do is actually install Foreman. And Foreman, if you didn't do these steps right here, would actually tell you you didn't do these steps. You need to fix this first. There's two ways to install the Foreman installer. One is Foreman-installer and just let it do its thing. If you do the -i at the end like this, that means do an interactive install, which is kind of what I wanted to do. And the reason I wanted to do it is because it shows you everything that it's trying to install. So Here's the main config menu for the installer and all the components you could potentially install as part of Foreman. And as you see, there's quite a few options, right? So it's only going to configure Foreman CLI, it's going to configure the proxy, and it's going to configure Puppet. And that's Puppet Server, not Puppet Agent or Puppet Master. So, but you got all these other options. And so as you install this, you can totally customize it and add additional options if that's what you want to do as part of your Foreman installer. We're going to do just the base one, save and run this. And this actually takes quite some time. It goes through all these preparing installation steps and then starts going on the install piece as well. And it chugs away for a long time. Probably took my computer 5 minutes to go through this. So I'm going to go ahead and pause it. I'll be right back. All right, so the installer finally finished. One thing you want to pay attention to is initial credentials. I don't know if you didn't pay attention to this when you did the installer. I'm not sure where you would find those. I'm sure there's some way to reset it, but I have a feeling that you're going to want to log that somewhere or change it as soon as you actually access it. So I've got it running here. I guess I should log out and show you. So basically, if you hit that URL, there we go. And we're going to go ahead and copy paste that password, log into it. It's going to take its time because it's slow, because it just finished installing, I would imagine. I mean, it's backed by an SSD, so I can't imagine it being that bad. So that's it. Foreman's installed. And it's got all kinds of cool stuff in here. This is I was checking this out in comparison to a Puppet Enterprise, which we use at my office. And some of it's somewhat similar. I could see these relating for sure, but obviously the interface looks different. But, you know, this is pretty cool because this is actually a really good looking interface, solid looking product. And I didn't have to pay for it, right? Whereas the Puppet server or Puppet Master is open source. I believe this is open source. I mean, I could be wrong, actually. I could be just spewing at this point. But I think it is. I mean, it didn't ask me to license. I don't believe that there's any license information on their website, like enterprise type support. It's community, right? There's nothing about, hey, purchase or pricing. So that's pretty cool. So this, there you go. Foreman is an open source product. I guess I should have read that. Project. And so it's a really good project. And this ends up, you know, turning out to be a pretty good solution. I'm going to try playing around with it for a little while and see how I can integrate it with existing systems and see how what the management and the categorization and whatnot looks like inside of this. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Look for more videos on Foreman to come soon. And thanks for watching.